are at the Wind River Range in Wyoming. We're gonna car camp for the night. As you can see, we got the FJ sitting over there on the hill. That's our little cozy spot for the night. So we're just gonna car camp there, try to get acclimated to this altitude. And then tomorrow, we hike to Big Sandy, camp for maybe the next three nights or so, and do some fishing. So stick around. It's gonna be awesome. The hike to Big Sandy was not my original plans. My original plans was to hike to Grand Teton National Park and do some camping and hiking there, but they had refunded my camping passes because since it was such a touristy area and since we were having the COVID-19 pandemic, my camping passes got refunded. So that was actually 2 weeks before leaving, so I had 2 weeks to make new plans. And I had no idea if they were going to work out or not. And I did some research, and the Wind River Range was still open to public. So that's why I'm here. Who says you can't sleep in an FJ? In a pinch, it'll work. Might not be the most comfortable place to sleep, but hey, it's a place to sleep regardless. This is awesome. It's everything I ever thought it would be.
How's it going?
Hey, good. How are you?
guys doing?
We're good. Gonna try to do some fishing.
Nice.
Yeah, man, you guys look like you've been a lot higher up than me.
Yeah. It should be fun though. It's melting fast and the lake up there is like starting to be pretty open. I bet it'll be awesome.
Yeah. Good. I'm, can't wait to do some trout fishing.
Yeah, have fun.
Yeah, thanks you guys. Be careful.
The weather there had warmed up quite a bit. And the week prior, it really started getting warm and the mountain was just covered in wet snow and snow packs everywhere. There was a few times where we had to trudge through some 3-foot snow packs. It was awesome. Lots of stream crossings. The water was just furiously running off the mountain and the rivers were loud. It was just an awesome experience. I've never experienced anything like that in my life. It was just a great experience. The hike was 6 miles to our camp, and I've never seen a little girl try to impress her father as much as she was trying. It just gave me a good warm feeling to have a child like that that wants to partake in outdoor activities and such.
There you go. Yeah.
So, as you can see, there was still ice on the lake, and fishing just wasn't good. I think if I would have waited 2 more weeks, the ice would have been completely gone for sure, and maybe fishing would have been a lot better. But it was still fun being out there. The weather was still decent enough to be by the water, and a little otter or a little muskrat swam by and said hello while I was fishing.
You're a little too close for comfort, bro.
Oh, man. Did you see that? There's a huge bright spot on that mountain. It's from the sun reflecting off the lake,
causing that beam of light.
This has been a lifesaver. And I was at a REI outlet, and that's a Sea to Summit little packable coffee filter so you can make pour over coffee. I've used it a lot, and it folds down. Still got coffee grounds in here. Anyway, packs down like that. And after you open it up, you just set it on your cup, put in your desired amount of coffee grounds, and pour in slow, and then it'll just kind of drip its way into your coffee cup.
Good stuff.
So the next mile meals is what me and Donna have been living off of for the past 5 days now, and I like them. She likes them. They're pretty easy to make. Only downside is they're a little expensive, but they're not bad for you, you know, unlike some of the other dehydrated meals. So if you're on keto or you're doing low carb, high fat, highly recommended. What you got going on here?
A little dam. That's a dock, and that's supposed to be a flag. And there's a little garden.
Get on this side.
I like it. That is really cool. What are you gonna call it?
Don't know yet.
We'll call it the Wind River Pier. How's that?
That's a good name.
All right, cool. Awesome. It's nice to know that you can bring your kids out here and they can find something to do and be creative and use their imagination. It's awesome. That wind has been crazy the whole time we've been here. I think we got a little moment to take a break from it. You can probably still hear it whipping through the trees and all, but this has probably been the most exhausting vacation I've ever taken, but it's been well worth it. A 20-hour drive straight and then rest for a night in the FJ, and then after that drive 4 more hours, hike 5 miles, get camp set up, and then maintain the camp for the rest of the time. It's hard work, but it's definitely worth it. Kid loves it. I don't think she's gonna be looking forward to the hike tomorrow, but neither am I. We're still kind of recovering from the hike from 3 days ago. All in all, it's a good trip. So in the morning, first thing, we're gonna get breakfast. I'll get my last bit of coffee I got left, and then we're gonna take off. And we're gonna go to Utah. I got a friend that said to stop by his house. He's got some camping gear for me, so I'm gonna go to Utah after this and raid his garage, I guess. Thanks, Tommy, appreciate it. Shut up. Man, these marmots are crazy. They remind me of a freaking fire alarm at your house that's going low on its battery. Shut up! Wow, what a learning experience for the both of us. I would definitely do it again, for sure. Probably try to plan a little bit better next time. Hopefully the COVID-19 pandemic is over by then. But wow, it was just so crazy, you know, with the high winds at night. If there was wildlife at night, I would have never heard it, because the wind was just one giant fan and really helped me sleep a lot better. We're almost back to the trailhead. From there, we're gonna
definitely try to find a place to clean up, get something to eat, and head over to Utah. Ah, man, what an awesome experience it was to be out here in the wild. Right? So, after 5 days of being out here with no shower and no cell service, I'm ready to get back to civilization. Man, it's hard. Woo!
I was really impressed with the Kafaru setup that I had. I had the camp bag on a 26-inch frame with the striker pack and the... I think that was the organizer guide lid also. Very nice setup. Expensive, yes, but for me to be out there in the wilderness with a good backpack really adds to the amount of confidence.